Coming up, we're on a sailboat ride to Isla, Mujeres via St. Pete. We have Troy Colson here who's going to fly me down to St. Pete, and I'll start my boat race on the Enigma.
Troy Colson's newly refurbished Cessna 182 has to be the best way to get to the St. Pete Yacht Club. The flight down the coast was spectacular, with sites like the Chazawitska National Wildlife Refuge and the Whooping Crane wintering site. On down the coast, we could see barrier islands like Anklode Key, and finally the crowded St. Pete Peninsula and the doomed Devil Rays Stadium on our left. As we landed, we could see the 46 sailboats that would be racing to Mexico the next day. The St. Pete Yacht Club was established in 1909. The club has over 2,500 members and has been hosting regattas for over 90 years. This is the 40th anniversary of the St. Pete to Mexico sailboat race, with 46 boats in the running. The boat I'll be sailing on is a 65-foot McGregor with a 75-foot mast. It's owned by friend Bob Parker, formerly of Crystal River and now residing in Key West. We caught up with Captain Bob down below, who was totally engrossed in pre-race boat preparations.
Okay, Captain Bob, what's going on here?
3 million wires. Just 3 million wires, that's all.
What are you doing? Tell me what you're doing.
I am trying to hook up the two battery system so I can charge independently my batteries. And that's not the way it's going right now.
The group just came back from the grocery store and Walmart. Uh-huh. At grocery store, we just got food provisions for the boat to make it to Mexico. Our stove broke, so we had to buy a little Coleman. And then we also buy soccer balls or basketballs that we bring over and we give to the kids that are over on Isla Mujeres because they love soccer and basketball.
As the 13-member crew arrived, they pitched in and began the myriad maintenance and repairs on the boat. With literally thousands of feet of lines and rigging, they worked until dark.
Okay, what's happening now? Where are we going?
All right, we're leaving the boat. We still got some more work to do, but we're going to go up to the skipper's meeting, which is a mandatory meeting. All the skippers have to be there. A lot of the crews will be there. And that'll probably go on for an hour. They'll give us all the particulars of the race and the parameters and what we do and what we can't do. And then there's a party afterwards. If we get our work done, we get to eat.
Coming up next is race day, with the start of the race to Isla Mujeres, Mexico.
Morning.
5:30 a.m., race day. About 5 hours of last-minute preparation before the start of this 500-mile race to Isla Mujeres, Mexico.
So you've gotten us up for showers. What's on the agenda today, Captain?
Packing. Getting this thing ready for sea.
Securing,
because there's no telling what's going to happen when we go out there. Right now, the wind's blowing about 7-8 miles an hour. It's going to be very lazy and easy, and everything's going to be beautiful, but it could turn 15-20 knots, and pardon my expression, all hell could break loose. And if we got stuff laying around, whatever's on the port side will be on the starboard side, whatever's on the starboard side will be on the port side.
So battery's charging good?
It seems to be working. I don't know. I think we just had a full battery last night, and the alternator wouldn't kick in, and sort of a problem.
You guys going to breakfast?
Well, we're going to get breakfast brush for everybody and brush our teeth.
Somebody dropped something.
Dropped a wrench in the water or something?
Yeah.
You're going in after it.
I'll go here.
What a hero.
No big deal.
Thank you. What do you need, Grampy? You got a bunch right here.
Except for my new 100% Kevlar.
Yeah.
We'll need it.
Yeah. That's for you.
The end of the pier.
Stow that below.
There you go.
Once the final prep work was done, it was time to cast off the lines and motor out to the starting area just off St. Pete Pier. Time's a race start.
We'll probably start about 10 or something, 10:05, about 10:20. Our actual start. This race starts at 10, but they'll have a 5 minute gun. Then the first class, which is the slowest class, will take off at 5 minutes. Then 5 minutes later, the next class, and then the third class will be the fast boat that's left. And we'll take off at 5, 10, 15. We'll take off probably 5, 10, 15, at time 50.
We're on our way out to the starting point, and looks like about a half an hour going to start.
I do have two pairs out, but Bill kept stealing.
Robin!
Winch handles!
We're getting ready to, we're hooking up the number one jib.
Yeah, I think Greg's running it.
We're not getting any slack. Is the stopper off? Don't go too far.
You guys need a longer boat.
Tell me what's going on, Joe.
All right, they're in the sequence of the first start, which gives us about 14 minutes to our start. And we want to be close to the heat, close to the mark, away from the pier, and clear air is our goal before the start.
Wait, Dave,
we got Tampa girl coming up.
15 seconds to our 5 minutes.
Boat coming over.
Head for the white, blue boat. Head for the blue boat.
The only boat you got to worry about is Catch Me Out.
I see Catch Me Out.
Okay, are we ready to trim? Are we ready?
I'm going to trim the jib or what?
Actually, I have to keep it down, Bob. Keep it down. Keep it down.
That guy's coming up to lure him.
Can you get behind Baylocks?
Get behind Baylocks.
The start of this race was one of the most exciting things I've ever witnessed.
Those two almost
touched. That's enough.
These two might touch. They're going to touch.
All of the boats to our port side have to tack back between us and the starting boat here. Otherwise, they'll be disqualified. Just watch and listen as tempers flare.
Five more now. Let's get through his bad air.
Get ready.
Okay, back to course.
Little man.
Main sheet in.
Oh, he's going up.
Yeah, he's down below.
He's coming down. Down is to us.
He is.
We're not going to pass him until we get below him, though. That's a big sail. We got him.
Oh, doesn't that help, though?
You came down to us. We didn't come up to you.
Come on up a little more. Hold it right there for a second. Let her eat.
Oh, you're like,
you're
good right here.
Okay, we had an exciting start here. Looks like we're leaving one class and catching up to the class that started 5 minutes ahead of us. So we're passing boats left and right here.
Yeah, all the boats behind us.
Mike, how you doing?
These are the guys, and as it started ahead of us, we're catching up to the next class here.
We came to get our $5 footlong, man.
Where's the food? Where's the
food?
How
you doing, Ron? Have a good trip.
What is the sail that we're looking at?
It's called a Code Zero, actually. It's
and your company built it, right?
It's a cross sort of between a Genoa and a Spinnaker.
But it's a huge sail. I mean,
it is. It's actually primarily used for close reaching, not quite upwind, although we do use it upwind. When we get a little bit wider off the wind, we'll put the spinnaker up, actually. So it's a nice groove for this boat because it goes so fast through the water, so easily driven, the apparent wind speed is always forward.
We have one more boat to pass, and then we'll have passed them all. We'll be in the lead.
Even the ones that started 15 minutes before us.
This is the last boat to pass. We're getting ready to put up the spinnaker for the first time. As soon as we shift going down, it'll pop. It's like shifting to another high gear, and bingo, we're gonna take off. We have just about passed everybody, and now we're gonna leave them out of the sun.
In the dust,
in
the ocean spray.
Yeah.
It's a race for the bridge, man. That's good.
It's on somewhere up there.
As we cross under the Skyway Bridge and leave Tampa Bay, there was an air of excitement by everyone on board. We'll be back with more sailing in a moment. The St. Petersburg to Isla Mujeres race is about 500 statute miles long. Every captain has his own strategy, balancing wind, current, and types of sails to use, when and how. The traditional route is to head more southerly, skimming the west coast of Cuba, then heading more westerly into the current and finally into Isla Mujeres. Every boat carries a transponder on board, which sends each boat's name, position, and speed to a satellite link. In turn, the race committee in Isla Mujeres can monitor each boat's whereabouts for a much safer race. About 3.5 hours into the race, the first of many setbacks happened when the Code Zero, the newest sail, split. I was below, heard a big bang, and ran up to see what happened.
I'm trimming.
It's free.
What happened?
About $10,000.
Huh?
About $10,000.
Of the sail rip? Which one? The jib?
The big Code Zero.
Oh, no.
Comes the big jib. That's a big one. That's a big broken one.
The whole trip never ceased to amaze me with sights like these love bugs. They were by the thousands out at sea and well away from land. And this pretty little bird who took a rest on our boat, no doubt migrating from Mexico to Florida.
I like tried to save my dog. I was like giving it water.
So do you have a nickname for this?
This is a Jerry Garcia.
The Jerry Garcia.
Tie-dye,
yeah.
Bring the spinnaker!
All that first day we sailed, with one other racer dogging us off our starboard side.
Yeah, as long as he sees us, he's got us. He's going to look over here and go, uh-oh, I don't like that. So he could sail away from it. Once we separate, then he has no clue where we are.
Mm-hmm.
So his best bet, because I have to give him time, like 3 hours. His best bet is just stay close to me.
Supper was spaghetti, and dessert was a beautiful sunset.
Easy, Halyard!
First night out, more bad news. Another sail torn.
This was our heaviest shoot, so I don't know what to tell you. You can only throw up so much sail, then you don't have any more.
Saturday, day two. The sea was higher and the crew sailed their hearts out. Starting with 7 sails, we were now down to 5 sails with 300 miles to go. But fate was not done with us yet, as a third sail tore. Later in the day, charging the batteries, the diesel motor developed a terrible knock and had to be shut down. We were now down to 4 sails and an engine that couldn't be trusted in a pinch. I couldn't help but think that we had a crew of 13, unlucky 13, and that might have something to do with our misfortune.
Okay.
What's going
on? We're running out of spinnakers.
Day 3. People are tired.
2 more sails have ripped. Now we're down to a mainsail and a jib. Captain Bob explains why sails rip.
The wind wants to force the boat up. It wants to ride up, ride up, ride up. The wind keeps getting faster and faster because the apparent wind keeps coming forward. You can't take it off, but what happens is once you get up so high, the spinnaker then collapses. Then you take it off, and then it fills. And when it fills sometimes, yeah. It's tissue paper. I mean, literally, that's what it is.
With less than 90 miles to go, spirits are high. By 4:30 in the afternoon, we spot Isla Mujeres.
Land ho!
Peace, everybody, to a hard fought race.
Woo!
That's a hard
fought
race.
Absolutely.
Come on in here, Martha.
Lots of fun, lots of lessons learned.
It's a quick sail past the Mexican Navy gunboat at the finish line.
Woo! Okay, let's
go. Woo!
Bring it to Maine, let's go.
Remember we had some engine problems? Well, we had to check out the prop to make sure it wasn't fouled.
What's the word?
It's all clear.
Despite 5 torn sails, Enigma miraculously crosses the finish line 2nd out of 46 boats. We'll be back with more of Florida Naturally in Isla Mujeres, Mexico in a moment. Isla Mujeres is an island about 8 miles off the coast of Cancun, Mexico. This narrow island is about 5 miles long, with the main town at the north end, with plenty of shops and restaurants. Traveling south is a scenic drive in a golf cart, the preferred mode of travel on this island. At the southern tip is a spectacular park with high cliffs and aquamarine water, overlooking Cancun 8 miles away. If you want to be the first to see the sunrise in Mexico, this is the place. If you'd like more information on Isla Mujeres, you can just Google Isla Mujeres or type in www.mexicorace.com. We hope you enjoyed tonight's show. Tune in every Friday night at 7:30 right here on WYKE. I'm Jeff Hall for Florida Naturally.
Captain Bob
is lost.
At the swing bar.
Lost at sea.
You don't understand.
I jumped off that boat almost.
God was with us. That's all I can say.
Took it down.
He took it down. That's right. That's one of the things. If you don't take your shoes down when you're supposed to, God will take them down for you.
Took all five of them down.
Yes, he did.